This video is about how to leverage neuro-linguistic programming in our presentations. What you're going to walk away with is a few ideas on how to incorporate the knowledge of neuro-linguistic programming into our presentations, whether they be on-site or remotely. So a lot of us do on-site presentations and a lot of us do remote demonstrations. I'm going to talk about them separately. When you're doing an on-site presentation, especially when it's multiple people, you have no idea what types of communicators they are or how they like to be communicated with. So you need to make sure that you're trying to connect with all three senses. Most presentation companies understand this, which is why you see manuals, because that's for the kinesthetics. They kind of touch and feel it. The PowerPoint presentation that goes up there, they use visuals, hopefully not too much text on the slides, because that kind of blurs it and makes it difficult to read. And then there's the auditory component where people are talking through things. The best presenters really are dynamic in mixing that up. You know, they show a few slides and then they shut the slide deck down, then they talk to somebody, and then they hand them something or get somebody to do something. So when you're face-to-face, really try to engage with all three senses, because it's really hard to try and figure out, as you're presenting, the type of communication style of each person. So I don't even try and think of it. That said, if I have somebody that I'm presenting with, and I'm either the secondary presenter, and I'm not the main one standing up there, I look at my job is to kind of scan the room and look at the main decision makers and to see if they're engaged in the presentation. And if they're not, find some eloquent way of kind of weaving into the presentation and taking over and pointing at that person and saying, you know what, let me show you something, or why don't you grab this and let's talk about that. Just to see if I can get them engaged to make sure that they're paying attention. Because there's one device that it's cracked to everybody, which is the BlackBerry, but it's super cracked to a kinesthetic. I mean, if you don't engage people in your presentations, they will be sitting in the back of the room pretending like they're paying attention. So that's when you're presenting in person. When you're doing an online demonstration or you're doing an online presentation, the problem with that is you have no idea what's happening on the other end of that phone. They could have just put you down, put you on mute, and picked up the phone every once in a while and said, yep, sure, no problem. So you're at a real disadvantage there. You know, that said, you're dealing with two senses, hopefully. You're showing them something, a demonstration, and they're listening to you, so the auditory piece is taken care of. But you gotta get them to do something. Even if it's just as simple as, hey, could you go to this website? Are you in front of your computer, obviously? Could you go to this part of the website and take a look at this and let me show you that, and then get them to click, 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 do something. Or even better, if you can hand the presentation over to them so they can start playing around with it and get them involved, that's the best way to do it. So just think about that. The takeaways from this one are just make sure you're paying attention to all three types, visuals, auditories, and kinesthetics, and try and incorporate and engage those people at all three senses. By doing different things with your presentations, whether they be on-site or online. Good luck and happy selling.